Hello everyone, myself Bhumi Patel, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. Today we will study about the different error analysis used in the feedback control system. So, what is the steady state error? As you know, we have studied in the last session, the steady state error is the difference between the input and the output of the system during the steady state. So, for accuracy, steady state error should be minimum. So, we know that this is the equation for the characteristic equation. Here E of s is equal to R of s upon 1 plus G of s H of s. Now the steady state error of the system is obtained by the using the final value theorem. So ESS is equal to limit t tends to infinite E of t is equal to s tends to 0 as E of s. So, ESS is equal to limit s tends to 0 as R of s upon 1 plus G of s H of s. We can put the value of E of s. So, now the unity feedback we can put H of s is equal to 1. So, ESS is equal to limit s tends to 0 as R of s upon 1 plus G of s. So, the steady state error depends on the input and the open loop transfer function. Now, today is steady state error for different type of system. Suppose we can use the type 0 system and the input of this system is unit step input. So, we can consider open loop transfer function. Here, G of s, H of s is equal to K 1 plus ht1, 1 plus ht2 upon s raised to m, 1 plus sta in bracket 1 plus stb. This is the equation number 1. Now here unit step input, so we can put R of s is equal to 1 by s. So, Kp is equal to, as you know, limit s tends to 0, g of s, h of s is equal to k. So, the steady state error ESS is equal to 1 upon 1 plus Kp. So, is equal to, Kp is equal to k. So, 1 upon 1 plus k. So, ESS is equal to 1 upon 1 plus k. Hence, the type 0 system, the static position error constant Kp is finite. Now, we can consider a unit ramp input. That means Kv is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into g of s h of s is equal to limit s tends to 0 s k 1 plus ht1 in bracket 1 plus ht2 upon 1 plus sta 1 plus stb is equal to, put s is equal to 0, so we can get 0 into this is equal to 0. So ESS is equal to 1 by kv, kv is equal to 0, so 1 by 0 is equal to infinite. So ESS is equal to infinite. Now type 0 system with unit parabolic input. Ka is equal to limit s tends to 0 s square g of s h of s is equal to limit s tends to 0 s square k into 1 plus ht1 in bracket 1 plus ht2 upon 1 plus sta 1 plus stb. Put s is equal to 0, so we can get 0. So ESS is equal to 1 by Ka, so is equal to ESS is equal to infinite. So, for type 0 system, the steady state error is infinite. For ramp and parabolic input, hence, the ramp and parabolic inputs are not acceptable. Now, the next one is the type 1 system with the unit step input. So, Kp is equal to limit s tends to 0, g of s, h of s. Put the value of g of s, h of s from equation number 1. So, Kp is equal to infinite. Okay. Now, ESS is equal to 1 upon 1 plus Kp. Put Kp is equal to infinite. So, 1 upon 1 plus infinite is equal to 0. So steady state error is equal to 0. Now type 1 system with unit ramp input KV is equal to limit S tends to 0 S into G of S H of S. So put the value of G of S H of S from equation number 1. KV is equal to K. So ESS is equal to 1 by KV. So it's equal to 1 by K. And for the unit parabolic input, we can get AA is equal to 0. So ESS is equal to 1 by KA is equal to infinite. So it is clear that for the type 1 system, step input and ramp input are acceptable and parabolic input is not acceptable. Now similarly, we can find the type 2 system. So for the type 2 system, all three input, step, ramp and parabolic are acceptable. So this is the comparison table of the type 0, type 1 and type 2 system. So for the unit step input in the type 0 system, we can get the answer ESS is equal to 1 upon 1 plus K. For type 1 it is 0 and for type 2 it is 0. Unit ramp input type 2 system is not acceptable because it is infinite. Same like for parabolic type 0 system is not acceptable. Now unit ramp input for type 1 system, the answer is 1 by K and for parabolic it is not acceptable. So type 1 system unit step and ramp acceptable. Type 2 system unit ramp, step and parabolic it is acceptable and unit step is acceptable only type 0 system. Now here we can take one example using mathematical modeling and solve using the second order parameter. Suppose a second order system example or a mechanical system example is given. As you know that this is the mass of the system, this is the spring constant and this is the damper of the system. The displacement of the system is x of t and the force applied of the system f of t, and here the value of force applied of the system is given to be 2 newton. And the second paragraph is given our equation that the graph is time t second versus x of t. And here the fixed value is given, it is 0.1, and we can get the peak value, peak overshoot at this is the second one, second two, second three, and this value is 0.0095 m. Okay. So first of all, in the mechanical system, we can draw the free body diagram. So here one displacement is given. So what node, put the one node with the X, we can connect M. K. And B. And the force is F. So this is the free body diagram. Okay, so first of all we can write the equation F of t is equal to M. Double derivation d square x upon dt square plus b single derivation plus a into displacement. Now Laplace transform of this equation fs is equal to m s square x of s plus b s x of s plus take x of s. Now f of s is equal to common the term x of s in bracket, we can get m s square plus b s plus k. Okay, so now the ratio of output upon input, it is the transfer function, so we can get 1 upon m s square plus b s plus k. So in general form, x of s upon f of s is equal to 1 by m. We can divide the whole equation with m, so we can get s square plus b by m s plus k by m. This is the equation number 1 for our mechanical system. Now we can compare with standard equation. So it is our standard equation, transfer function is equal to omega n square upon s square 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. This is the equation number 2. So compare equation number 1 is equal to 2, we can get omega n square is equal to, you can see that it is the k by m. So omega n is equal to under root of k by m. This is the equation number 3. Now 2 zeta omega n s is equal to b by m s. So zeta is equal to b upon m 2 omega n is equal to b upon 2m, and omega n is equal to under root of k by m. So is equal to b under root of m, m upon 2 into m into under root of k. So is equal to b upon 2 under root of m k. This is the equation number 4. Zeta is equal to, okay. Now here gain is equal to 1 by k from figure number 2. So it applies the equation, steady state value is equal to amplitude of the step input into gain of the system. Gain of the system is also given in the equation. So here the steady state, where the graph is steady at the 0.0095 value. Now the amplitude of the step input is given to the equation, and it is given to 2, and gain of the system is also given 1 by k. So k is equal to 2 upon 0.0095. So k is equal to, we can find the value, it is 210 into 53 newtons per meter. Now we have to find the value of m and d. So from figure 2, mp is equal to, here you can see that this is the mp, difference between this. So mp is equal to 0.0095 upon 0.1, so it is 0.095. raised to minus pi zeta upon under root of 1 minus zeta square. We have value of mp 0.095 is equal to e raised to minus pi zeta upon under root of 1 minus zeta square. So we can write this equation like this, e raised to pi zeta upon under root of 1 minus zeta square is equal to 1 upon 0.095 and is equal to 10.52. So we can find the antilog of this. So zeta pi upon under root of 1 minus zeta square is equal to ln 10.52. So we can get zeta pi upon under root of 1 minus zeta square is equal to value of ln 10.52 is equal to 2.3538. So zeta pi is equal to 3.14 is equal to 2.3538 into 1 under root of 1 minus zeta square. So zeta is equal to 0.749 under root of 1 minus zeta square. Now square both sides, we can get zeta square is equal to 0.561 1 minus zeta square. So zeta square 1 plus 0.561 is equal to 0.561. So zeta square is equal to 0.561 upon 1.561. So we can get zeta square is equal to 0.3596. So zeta is equal to 0.5996. So zeta is equal to 0.6. So we can get zeta is equal to 0.6. Now from figure 2, as you know, here this is the 2 seconds and this 2 seconds is known as the peak time. So TP is equal to 2 seconds. Now equation of TP is equal to pi upon omega of T is equal to 2, and pi is equal to 3.14, and omega D is equal to omega n under root of 1 minus zeta square is equal to 2. Now zeta is equal to 0.6, so we can get 3.14 is equal to 2 into omega n under root of 1 minus 0.6 square. So omega n is equal to 3.14 upon 2 into 1 minus 0.36. So omega n is equal to 3.14 upon 2 into 0.8. So omega n is equal to 1.96, and the unit of omega n is equal to radian per second. So this is the value of omega n. Why we can find the zeta and omega n? Because we can find the value of m and p. So now here, as you know, m is equal to k upon omega n square. From equation number 3, so we can get k is equal to 210.53 and omega n is equal to 1.96 square. So we can get m is equal to 54.8, and this is the mass. So unit of mass is kilogram. Now the last is to find the b. So from equation, b is equal to 2 zeta under root of mk. Put the value of 2 into zeta is equal to 0.6, into under root m is equal to 54.8 and k is equal to 210.83. So simplify this equation, we can get b is equal to 128.89 Nm/s. So using the second order parameter delay time, peak time, peak over shoot and zip time omega n, we can also find the value of mechanical system mass, spring and damper. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt, then contact me in this email ID.